Yes, Jill. A body was found here on this patch of wasteland early this morning. The police are still searching the scene and questioning anyone who might have seen something, but no information has filtered through yet concerning the identity of the victim. Of course, everyone's wondering if the body is that of Jeremy Bowles and has the Oregon Tourist Collide report as soon as we have any information.
The zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m. Related to the investigation. Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning, they told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, can you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything.
Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Listen, you look busy. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden, you come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body.
Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims. Harry, comment. Sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Harry, comment. The pollen particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail. Harry, comment. Traces of blood on the railroad track. Analysis confirms it comes from the victim. Footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers.
unmarried Comet. There are traces of blood on the fence behind the railroad line. It comes from the victim. The killer came this way with the body and probably grazed it on his way through the fence. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Harry, come in. Tire tracks on the side of the boat behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car. You have seen all there is to see.
Heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
Don't think, Ethan. Give me the first idea that pops into your head.
A bat. A fox. Two faces back to back. Blood. Blood spreading through water.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
I know he's disappointed in me. I'm not the father I used to be. He's a great kid, you know. He deserves better.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I stopped living at the same time Jason did. When that car ran into us.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later, but I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. You want to eat something? Aren't you going to go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's gonna send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay? I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah!
Come on, Dad, make me fly!
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great! Dad, as fast as you can. Faster! Faster! Come on! Faster, faster!
Good training for astronauts, though. You want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. Pushing Dad. Come on, Dad, higher.
Ha ha ha!
That was cool.
I'd like a packet of strawberry-flavored chewies, please. Thanks. Hey, I got you some chewies.
I hate strawberries. Thanks. It was nice of you anyway.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket. One, please.
That's a dollar.
Stop! Stop!
Do you think it's going to take long?
No, he should be finished soon.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. I'll cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you. I'm in a bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course. I wanted to introduce myself before getting started, but perhaps there's a better time.
No, it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get them well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press... they're all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out. Then the press get onto it, and we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
No, of course not. All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Well, I hope you're better at profiling than at tying knots. Oh, forget it, I'll manage. Oh, go see Charlene, she'll show you to your office. Check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We've bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Congratulate Larry on my behalf.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work. Step one, change the office. Eight victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13. No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything. Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later, drowned in rainwater. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall.
The killer has a large comfort zone. He gained confidence rapidly and moved away from his base. This won't make the geoprofiling any easier. There is always a railroad line adjacent to where the bodies are found. And all the victims disappeared in the fall. Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned. Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on. The killer is white, age between 30 and 45. He is intelligent, calm, and determined. An organized type. He has a car. He's probably employed, but his work allows him free time. Wash my face. I need to take some. I'm gonna faint if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
Is everything all right, sir?
No one. No one must see.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marshall. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Sean. We played together for a while. And then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses. And when I turned back, Sean had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Mars. Every detail can be important.
It must have been about 4:15. Yeah, that's it, 4:15. I remember exactly because I looked at the clock in the park when we arrived.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat. A beige coat. And a pair of pants. Green pants.
How could Sean have disappeared without you even noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I did. I didn't leave. I watched the carousel.
How could Sean possibly have vanished if you were right there watching the carousel?
I don't know. I don't understand.
You say you took your son to the park after school. But you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
Did Sean have any particular difficulties, Mr. Mars? Anything that might have caused him to run away?
No, I don't think so.
Everything okay at school? Any particular problems between you and your wife?
No, nothing in particular.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Sean overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Do you think the origami killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple of hours.
But what if it is the origami killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
What happened, Ethan? How could you lose Sean like that? You should never have taken your eyes off him. I mean, for God's sake, how hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. It's not what I meant to say.
Thank you.